They're super cute, but their bites pack a deadly punch. These are Sunda slow lorises. Oh, they look like flat teddy bears here. They've got this toe that has a claw on it. It's a grooming claw. I think maybe some of the uncles have it. They've got like a very large nail. Hi, my name is Marcus. I'm the curator of mammals at the Lee Kong Chian Natural History Museum. I look after our collection of mammals that spans back to the British era from the late 1880s. In the past, the animals that were studied would be shot or captured and brought back to the museum to be preserved as a specimen. Today, we rely a lot on salvage specimens. Salvage specimens are specimens that we get from animals that have died from either natural causes or human causes, such as roadkill. In the old days, we were called body snatchers. We get a call, we go down. We're fighting with NEA, basically. So their job is to clear up the streets as much as possible. That's their KPI, but our job is to get the carcass before they do. We're now in the museum's collection area, and to my right are compactors holding some 10,000 mammal specimens, and they're all under my care. It's like Indiana Jones, like the walls come closer and closer. They are like library books, except they are dead. So a dead animal can tell us so much, can get information about where this animal was, the habitat in that area, what it has eaten, and even the pollutants that it has accumulated in its body. So even for specimens that are more than 100 years old, we can get DNA, bacteria and viruses that might still be on them, even parasites. They might be able to inform us about environment at that time where it was collected and might be useful for disease surveillance, studies about climate change or ecological changes as well. Most of the reds are male and most of the greys are female. So they glide across the expressway sometimes and they don't make it and the cars go over them. Or they might get hit while they're gliding. When I first started working in the museum about 2009, I used to pick up roadkills more frequently, maybe once in a month or two or three times a month. But now where there is a more integrated wildlife network in Singapore for roadkills, most of the roadkills are picked up by NParks or their contractors and acres, and they get sent to the zoo. So we are now here at the Mandai Wildlife Group Wildlife Health and Research Centre, and we're going to pick up a lesser mouse deer carcass.
Yeah, I hope we don't get more.
Dr. Chata, the pathologist, mentioned that it was still alive when it got to Mandai, but it seemed to be paralyzed from the back, so he suggested that it might have been hit by an object or blunt trauma. So this could have been either a mountain bike in a habitat in the forest or some other injuries that it might have sustained. Let's go. So this is the museum's freezer room. You can see the plethora of freezers we have in here. You can see what was here before. Presbytis, Bennett Langer, there's a bamboo bat, greater mouse deer, otter DNA samples. So this afternoon, we'll be processing a lesser mouse deer that we picked up from the zoo. As you can see, we only have one specimen. The label tells us it was collected at Changi in 1912. And so whatever we do today would be a valuable addition. Less than 1 kilogram. Great condition, so we could make a good specimen out of probably her. The zoo vets have left us the poop. We could actually use DNA analysis to find out what the animal has been eating. They look like tiny bubble tea pearls. And I'm gonna make my unholy bubble tea by dropping all of them in ethanol. So people ask, why do we keep collecting, even though we've collected so many in the past? Some species might be really rare. Each specimen, it's a physical record of an animal. So it's something that cannot be replaced with a photo or a written account of it, because it's something that you can come back to, remeasure, get more information out with better technology in the future. Yeah, basically it just smells like meat, very fresh meat. When we get a specimen, we first remove any part of the animal that can rot, the eyes, the innards, the limbs, the body, the muscles. And of course, we preserve the important parts like the skull, stomach contents, some tissue for DNA, and we're left with the skin. What we want to preserve is the colours, as well as the form of the animal when it's alive. So we'll be stuffing the animal with a non-biodegradable material, sewing it up, and then drying up the skin. A little known fact is that Raffles was also a naturalist. He also came for the animals that he came to discover. In the old days, when people were preparing specimens, it was not uncommon for them to eat with what they prepared. In fact, Raffles actually noted in his description of a dugong, I think word for word, the quote was, "most excellent beef." So we don't only do roadkills, but we do sea kill as well. So this sperm whale was hit by a ship. It's most memorable because it's the largest salvage we had so far. It took a team of five, about 70 days to process the carcass on site. Processing this specimen was tough also because of the smell. The smell was so deadly that we were all very conscious and afraid to take public transport after we were done. Yeah, experience of a lifetime. I'm very tempted to lick the thread, but I know I shouldn't. So my home economics teacher would be proud. The most common salvaged animals would be civets, colugos, and pangolins. About 50% of the animals that we receive are roadkill, and with that, we could try to mitigate roadkills in Singapore. We can find out hotspots. Agencies can identify places where they can put fencing, slow down the roads with speed bumps or warning system for drivers. We're gonna work fast. The skin is drying out. Yeah, it's already looking like a specimen. So I'm just gonna put it in the dryer, and it goes into this oven here. Looks like it's being baked, but it's just gonna dry out for a week at 60 degrees Celsius. Yeah, last week looked a bit like a wet dog going in, but this week looks fine after drying. So this is like almost like scientific unboxing. I think it's okay. Not my best work, 7 out of 10. Although I find the process of specimen salvage and preparation to be really time consuming, I don't dread it. I see this as a time investment in a specimen that will last way past my time and be useful for scientists in the future.